do that while I'm talking. And this is a, like I said, it's a live, this is like multiple object tracking live, unplugged. I need someone to throw out the, would you like to do that? So, that's good, but now just do it one more time. First law of the aphorism is it must be brief. Why? Because only a fool gives a speech in a burning house. Second law, it must be definitive. There are no ifs, ands, or buts about aphorisms. Aphorists tell it like it is, or at least like they say it is. Samuel Johnson, patriotism is the last refuge of a scoundrel. Ambrose Bierce said, patriotism is the first refuge of a scoundrel. Both are aphorisms, but they're contradictory. So it doesn't really matter if you agree or disagree, or if you think an aphorism is true or untrue. It doesn't matter, as long as it's definitive. The third law is, aphorisms must be personal. This is the difference between an aphorism and a proverb. Let sleeping dogs lie. That was once an aphorism, when it was first originated by the person who first thought of it. But centuries of use have worn away the identity of the author, so it becomes a proverb. Self-love is the beginning of a lifelong romance. That is an aphorism because it's got Oscar Wilde written all over the lines. Please hold your applause at the end. Fourth law of the aphorism must be philosophical. This is the difference between an aphorism and a platitude. Love means never having to say you're sorry. That's a platitude because, in my experience, love means having to say you're sorry on a regular basis. But also, it's not philosophical, it's not provocative, it doesn't make you think. Much more philosophical, therefore much more aphoristic, is love is that brief moment of time when someone else feels the same way about us as we do about ourselves. The fourth law of the aphorism, or the fifth law, sorry, is why aphorisms are like jokes. There's a moment when you get an aphorism, just like you get a joke. And it's also why aphorisms are like juggling. Aphorisms lift you up out of your familiar psychological environment, and they put you down somewhere where you least expect it to be. And that's why the fifth law of the aphorism is, it must have a twist. Oh.